गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। एज यू नो वी आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ द पावर प्लांट इंजीनियरिंग। नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फ्यूल ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल। सो शैल आई स्टार्ट? ओके। इन दैट प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सॉलिड फ्यूल। Now I am considering one example of solid fuel. That example is a great return as 5 to 10 centimeter. If the gate is written in 5 to 10 centimeter, the indication of the coal as having with the size. For example, 5000 ASF24S16. This is one type of grade. That grade is showing how much the capacity of heating value, ash percentage, softening temperature, sulfur content. These are the things the grade is telling. Behind the grade, we can see this all in deep material quantity as well as the capacity. Now we are discussing about the liquid fuel. Liquid fuel is a cheap sources we can easily buy and we can easily obtain from the earth or natural resources. And this is a very important advantage in comparison to sold fuel in the following respective. For wherever you go, if it is the engine or motor, the compression stroke will be there. That compression, with the help of liquid fuel, the compression stroke will be done. Either whatever may be the fuel is diesel, petrol, kerosene, different hydraulic fuel is there. Whatever may be the fuel will be there. In that compression, the stroke it requires. That's why it's a more advantage. Require less space wherever you go, and wherever you want to store the liquid fuel, you can easily store the liquid fuel with less requirement space. Higher calorific value. Here the liquid fuel higher calorific value is there, easy to control arc of consumption. We can easily control our consumption, staff economy, absence of dangers from symptoms, symptomatic combustion, easily handling and transportation. Cleanliness, no ash problem. There is no ash problem or non-deterioration of the oil in storage. For example, we are considering here the petroleum. These are the different opinions regarding the origin of petroleum. Everyone have different opinion regarding the petroleum. Those who are working in the petroleum sector or those who are producing the petroleum. However, now it's accepted the petroleum. Nowadays we are thinking like petroleum is like a important resources from the earth, like fish or plant. How much we are giving the priority of fish or plant, like that we are giving nowadays petroleum. Because of day by day the petroleum cost will be increased, and our requirement of traveling, that also increasing. Now heavy fuel oil or crude oil is an important in India. We can say that India, we can see the in India the petroleum resources is in Assam or Gujarat. In Assam or Gujarat the refineries are there. Heavy fuel or crude oil is important and then refined at different refineries. In that different refineries we can refine the heavily fuel or crude oil. The refine of the crude oil supply to the most important product called petrol. whatever we are generating the refineries with the help of refineries crude oil, that is the most important product of the petrol. And petrol can also be made by polymerization of refinery gas. If we are refining, if we are refining the polymerization gas, we can easily get the petrol. Other liquid fuel are kerosene fuel, oil, collodial fuel, and alcohol. These are the other liquids of the fuel. The following tables give now. Next page, we can easily comparison between the liquid fuel and its terms of elements and how much the weight percentage will be there. Now we will discuss that is the differences or important properties of liquid. Whatever may be the liquid is kerosene, petrol, fuel, or liquid or diesel, whatever may be the liquid fuel is there, that every liquid fuel having properties same compared to, but the percentage or capacity level will be varying. Specific gravity, here the specific gravity is there, the flash point, fire point, volatility, pore point, viscosity, carbon residues, octane number, cetane number, corrosive properties, ash content, gum content, heating value, sulfur content. These are the 14 properties of liquid. Every liquid having these all 14 properties, but the capacity ratio or the percentage will be different. If we are considering the higher fuel, in the general higher fuel, the liquid should have low ash content. If you are considering the general liquid fuel, in that liquid fuel, normally we are seeing for the for our requirement purpose, the content of low ash, high heating value. Normally we are using for liquid fuel for the purpose of to generate high heating value, low ash content, less corrosive tendency, low gum content, low sulfur content and low pore point. These are the basic general purpose for the requirement to use a liquid fuel. Viscosity and other properties from varying for other purpose. If our requirement is more or different compared to traveling of automobiles, different types of machineries is there. As per the requirement, we are considering that different properties also. Now we will discuss about the gaseous fuel. Natural gas, the main important part of the gaseous fuel. Here the different types of gaseous fuel are natural gas, coal gas, coke oven gas, blast furnace gas, producer gas, water or illuminating gas, or the last one is the sewer gas. These are the different types of gaseous fuel. In that different types of gaseous fuel, everyone having the calorific value is different, and then heating value is also different. Remember this. And these are the gases generally we are considering for internal combustion engine. For example, natural gas calorific value is 21,000 kilojoules per meter cube, and it is prepared from methane or ethane. Like coal gas is preparing from hydrogen, carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons. Coke oven gas is preparing from bituminous coals, and the violet content of coal is driven off by heating, and the major portion of the gas is utilized for the purpose of heating the ovens. The gas must thoroughly filtered, the coke oven gas thoroughly filtered the gas and then passed to the gas engine. Then only in that gas engine combustion take place in the good way. blast furnace gas. In that blast furnace gas, the smelting operation in which the air is forced through the layer of coke and iron ore. For example, we are considering the blast furnace, pig iron manufacturing, where it is a gas is produced. If we are producing the pig iron, that the manufacturing where this gas is produced as by a product and contain about 20% carbon monoxide. If we are producing the blast furnace gas inside a blast furnace gas, that gas 20% carbon monoxide is there, and after we are filtering the rich gas, or this gas is using in the gas engine directly, and is also a heating value is low compared to the other gases. What is producer gas? The producer gas is a partially oxidized of coal or coke or peat. It is a partially gases. It's a mixture of gas. We can say that the coal or peat, when they are burned, if these three are burned with an insufficient quantity of air, at the time of movement, we can produce the producer gas to restore to retrace the point of low heating point value, in general suitable for large installation. With the low heating point value, we can use for the large installation purpose, and it is also used in steel industry. Nowadays, we can see easily in that steel industries for firing open heating furnace. In that steel industry, we can easily see for the work in that section of firing open, how they are firing open of hot furnace. Water or illuminating gas. What is water illuminating gas? Illuminating gas is also producing from blowing steam. Whatever the steam will be goes on in any hot coke or coal, that blowing steam take place and liberating from free hydrogen. That is blowing steam, there is no hydrogen and oxygen in the steam, and combined with the carbon, and that steam we are combining with the carbon to form the carbon monoxide. Here we are seeing the chemical equations also. The steam carbon plus hydrogen or H2O water contain and give rise to CO plus H2 is a product. After the reaction, the product will be CO plus H2. CO stand for carbon monoxide, and H2 you know already hydrogen contain. The gas composition varies as the hydrogen contain if the coal is used. If we are using the gas in terms of hydrogen, if the coal is used, the gas composition is varying compared to the carbon, compared to the hydrogen content, compared to the different element content, for the purpose of to produce more heat in that coal. Sewer gas is obtained from sewer disposed vat in which fermentation and decay occur. It consists of many marsh gas CH4 and is collected at large disposal plants. We can collect this sewer gas in large disposal plant, and it work as a fuel of gas engine. Sewer gas is working as a like a fuel of gas engine, and it is give in that combustion take place to run and drive the plant's pumps. Whatever the plant's pumps are there, that pumps are producing the heat energy from the sewer gas. Now we discuss about the advantage of gas fuel. Why we are discussing this solid fuel, liquid fuel, gas fuel? We are already discussed in the first chapter, first section or first lecture about the power plant engineering. In that introduction, what is energy, sources of energy, or what is power? We are already discussed where we are finding this power plant engineering. Our different name of power plant engineering is power station engineering. In what is the basic advantage? These all are things we are discussing in that lecture one. But this is the in our day life. What is the importance of power plant engineering is, you know, if we are working in any organization of manufacturing sector. What we are producing, how we are manufacturing, and how we are traveling, in how we are giving the surety content to the customer, or how much we are producing and supplying to the by the travels to the customer. These are, and which gas we are preferring to run the machines in our manufacturing sector. With if the machine will run coal gas, for example, machine will run coal gas instead of coal gas. If we are using coke oven gas, whether it is useful for whether it is advantage or whether it is benefit for us or not, we can see this type of things and we can modify the machines also. These are the things we have to take care whenever we are working in any manufacturing sector. First of all, we have to do in dummy model. After that, we can proceed the, if it is successful, we can proceed the in that machine. So next is the advantage. Here we are discussing about the advantage of the gas fuel. The first one is better control of combustion. It is a better controlling of combustion, either we are comparing to liquid or solid. Much less excess air is needed for complete combustion. Here the less air requirement for to complete the combustion, as well as the economic in the fuel and more efficient for furnace operation. If we are doing the furnace operation, that is more efficient, easily maintenance of oxidizing or reducing atmosphere, cleanliness, no problem of storage. If the supply is available from public, we can easily supply line from our manufacturer to the public line also. The distribution of gas fuel even over a wide area is through the pipe. If the distribution of a gas is if the supplier are more, so at the time of movement we can distribute the gas through the pipelines also. Fuel is altogether eliminating gas fuel, give economic of heat and production, higher temperature, and they can preheated in regenerative furnace, and thus heat from the hot fluid gas can be recovered. There is no problem if we are supplying the gas fuel for through the pipelines to the customers. Important properties of gas fuel. In previous topic we are discussing just now the important properties of liquid fuel. Now we are discussing about gaseous fuel. Heating value or calorific value, in that property gaseous fuel, the main property is how much the capacity of heating value or calorific value is there. The viscosity, specific gravity, density and diffusibility, type of composition, type of composition of some gases fuel is given below. These are the typical composition of some gases like fuel is considering the different types of elements of chemical. Natural gas is considering coal gas, blast furnace gas, calorific or heating value of fuel. The calorific value of the fuel is defined as the energy now what we are discussing, sorry for that, just I am not So shall we start again? What is calorific value or heating value of the fuel? Calorific value is nothing but is like in energy of liberated by the complete oxidation. Whenever the oxidation is completed of in that unit mass or volume of fuel in that combustion chamber after the expansion process. That is the calorific value in that producing the energy. Fuel contain and it is expressed in kilojoules per kg for solid liquid fuel. For solid and liquid fuel, in that calorific value is expressing in terms of unit kilojoules per kg for solid, for liquid kilojoules per meter cube for gases. Which fuel contain hydrogen have two calorific value. Like if we are considering the element of chemical or fuel of hydrogen, that hydrogen having two calorific value. Higher also there, lower also there. The lower calorific value is liberated from per kg capacity of fuel after deducting the heat necessary to vaporize the steam. If we are using the hydrogen fuel, after the heat necessary to complete the compression stroke, the compression stroke in the steam engine to vaporize the steam from the hydrogen. The higher or gas, generally we can say that lower calorific value is nothing but heat is liberated per kg capacity. Heat is liberated means lower calorific value. Beyond the per kg capacity, heat is liberated and means higher calorific value for the hydrogen fuel. Here the lower calorific value and higher calorific value equation is there. If we are considering in MKS unit, the lower calorific value is different and the saturation temperature is also different. If we are considering the general in different SI unit, calorific value is equal to higher calorific minus 2465 MW. What is MW? It is a mass of water vapor, okay, for the combustion for 1 kg. As you know, 2464 kilojoules per kg is the latent heat, and we are minusing the latent heat from higher calorific value, then we can easily get the lower calorific value. Like that, MKS unit will be there, where dongle formula. After the MKS unit, dongle formula for Duolong formula. Solid, we can say that the dongle or Duolong formula. Solid liquid fuel dongle formula is nothing but we have suggested the formula for calculating purpose only, for the calorific value. If the problem will comes for in that power plant engineering, the basic problems will be definitely comes in that your exam. The question will ask you like this: how we will be calculate the calorific value as per the liquid fuel or liquid solid fuel or gaseous fuel. That the basic calorific value calculation, the formula is here: HVC, higher calorific value, is equal to 1 by 100 into 33,800 carbon plus 14,400 into hydrogen minus oxygen by 8 plus 99,270 S into kilojoules per kg. This is the formula for finding the calorific value. Next, in that MK system is different, okay, where C, H, O and S are different types of carbon, are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur. Just now I told you what is C. C is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and S for sulfur. In that, the percentage respectively, and 100 kg of fuel we are supplying, how 100 kg as per the requirement of fuel. In the above formula, the oxygen is assumed to be combination with hydrogen and only extra sulfur hydrogen supply the necessary heat. These are the above calorific value for calculation formulas. In that calorific value formulas, the oxygen is assumed for the purpose for only the extra sulfur hydrogen is supplying. If we are supplying the extra hydrogen sulfur so we have to take care the oxygen is there or not. Assume like constant energy store in water. Energy, how much energy will store in water, we have to discuss about that. The main thing is there, and which energy will be generated in that energy in that water, and where it is will be there. Water power is acute cheap where water is available in abundance. Although the capital cost of hydroelectric power plant is higher or compared to other types of power plants, yet their operating costs are quite low also. With the help of water, we can easily generate the electricity, and that is very cheaper for compared to others, and we can generate as per our requirements also. Now after that, nuclear energy, that is very important and it is not easy to generate also. One of the outstanding facts about the nuclear power is the large amount of energy that can be released from a small mass of active material. If we are considering the small active material, that active material gives the large amount of nuclear energy. Like complete fission of 1 kg of uranium contains the energy equivalent of 45,000 tons of coal or 2,000 tons of oil. 1 kg of uranium प्रोड्यूस द न्यूक्लियर पावर ऑफ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इन टर्म्स ऑफ 4,500 टन्स ऑफ कोल और 2,000 टन्स ऑफ द ऑयल नॉट 45 अगेन आई एम टेलिंग टू यू फॉर 4,500 टन्स ऑफ कोल और 2,000 टन्स ऑफ ऑयल द न्यूक्लियर पावर इज नॉट ओनली अवेलेबल इन अबंडेंस बट इट्स चीपर देन द पावर जनरेशन बाय कन्वेंशन सोर्सेज वेयर एवर द कन्वेंशनल सोर्सेज इज देयर दैट प्लेस एंड दैट रिक्वायरमेंट द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी इज चीपर बट फॉर द डोमेस्टिक पर्पज इट्स नॉट अ चीपर द फॉलोइंग फैक्टर्स गो इन अ फेवर ऑफ न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी दीज आर द फोर फैक्टर्स आर देयर फॉर द फेवरिंग ऑफ न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी इज आर गुड और नॉट आर इट्स गिव द एनर्जी एंड इट इज एडवांटेज और नॉट सो पार्शियली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ जियोग्राफिकल फैक्टर नो कंबंशन प्रोडक्ट्स इट्स देर इज नो कंबंशन प्रोडक्ट्स देर क्लीन सोर्सेस ऑफ पावर विच डज नॉट कंट्रीब्यूट टू एयर पोल्यूशन हियर द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी इज नॉट कंट्रीब्यूटिंग द एयर पोल्यूशन आफ्टर द एग्जॉस्ट फ्यूल ट्रांसपोर्ट नेटवर्क एंड लार्ज स्टोरेज फैसिलिटी नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इज ऑल्सो लार्ज स्टोरेज फैसिलिटी इज ऑल्सो नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी 75% ऑफ ग्रेविटी बेस लोड अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक एडवांटेज ऑफ न्यूक्लियर पावर कैन बी रिलीज्ड वी कैन रिलीज द न्यूक्लियर पावर इन टर्म्स ऑफ 75% विंड पावर द मेन has been the man has been served by the power from winds for many centuries but the total amount of energy generated in this manner is small in our history the man is applying the force on the wind power and that wind is moving around the circular part then wind give the power and that power is compared to the man force is applying in it is small the expansion of installing and variety of operating have tended to limited the use of windmill to intermittent serve where it is variable output has no serious disadvantage the principal service of this nature are the pumping of water into the store tank and the charging of store battery wherever we are seeing the windmill the for the windmill purpose is wherever the air will touches the windmill moves and that windmill give the energy to the pump to lift the water either it is ground to top or else travel from one place to other place or in the windmill also charge the batteries Next, windmill power equipment may be classified as follows. These are the classifications of windmill. The multi-bladed turbine wheel. This is one type of windmill. High speed propeller type or else third one is rotor also. Next, the propeller and rotor types are suitable for the generation of electrical energy if we are generating the electrical energy we where in that place we can use the propeller propeller or rotor types of windmills, as both them possess the ability to start in very low wind. If the wind is low or very low, then they having a capacity to generate the electricity or to start the windmill also. That's why we are using for in that electrical energy side propeller or rotor types windmill. The propeller types is more likely to be used in small units such as a driving of small batteries charging generation, where the rotors which is rarely seen, but the rotors windmill we can see in the rarely sight, and it is a more partially for large installation, because of large installation even of several hundreds kilowatts capacity, but here producing the several hundred kilowatts capacity, but the installation and the working is compared to the propeller propeller windmill is less. In India, wind velocity along coastal line has a range 10 to 16 kilometers, and the survey of wind power has revealed that wind power is capable of exploitation for pumping water from depth well or for generating a small amount of electric energy. In India, the range of the coastal line should be there. However, we cannot establish or we cannot install anywhere the windmill. We have to take care the rules and regulations of as per the windmill and as per the range of the kilometers also, or modern windmill also 3 to 7 kilometers, while the maximum efficiency is 10 kilometers per hour. For these the things we have to take care whenever we are installing the windmill. A normal working life of 20 to 25 years. Windmill is a working life is 20 to 25 years. After that, the in yearly the service will be there, but the 20 to 25 years after that, the efficiency is less compared to the normal. Like our motorcycles also, after 15 years the efficiency will not be there as per the new vehicles or else three old vehicles. The great advantage of the sources energy is that no operator is needed and no maintenance and repair are necessary for a long interval. There is no operator need and no maintenance cost, no repairing necessary for long. If we are installing the windmill for this year, we can we should not take care, we should not worried about anything the windmill maintenance side, or no operator is needed for no repairing for this. If the airflow is more beyond the windmill, maybe it will damage. If it is more, it's not like more like cyclone type, it's not like this here. If it is like this cyclone type, maybe it will damage in that case, but different case there is no need for repairing or no need for maintenance also. Characteristics of wind power and energy. Here the characteristics, some characteristics are there. No fuel provisions and transport are required for wind energy system. Renewable sources energy, here the it's a good advantage, and the wind power system are non-polluting. Whenever the wind power system is using, there is no polluting in that air, wind power system up to few kilowatts are less costly, produce the electricity in but few kilowatts are less costly, but a large scale, but the shape or but the size of the windmill is large, cost can be competitive with conventional electricity. Lower cost can be achieved by mass production. Cost is a good advantage, but the lower cost is achieved by the mass production. Problem associated with wind energy. How much which problems will associate with wind energy? Wind energy system are noisily in operation. Noisy in operation. Whenever the windmill move or run, the produce the noisy in operation. Large area is needed to installation wind farms for electrical power generation, and around the windmill we have to take care of the things will not be there, like homes. Next one is wind energy available is dilute and fluctuating in nature. Because of dilute form is converting station machine have, it is necessary large. If it is a wind is coming from one side, the winds will be moved as per the winds. If it is comes the air or wind from other sides, the wind will move as per the wind sides. Wind energy needs store maintenance. Storage means because of the irregularity. Because of wind, sometimes the wind will flow right hand side, wind will flow a right hand side to left hand side, and sometimes it flow left hand side to right hand side. That's why the storage energy is needed. Solar energy. You know already solar energy, the solar panels will be there. For the solar panels, for the helping of with the help of solar panels we can easily generate the electricity, and we can store the electricity in that batteries from the sun rays. The sun rays will touch the solar panels, and the solar panels is generating the electricity, and that electricity we can use in that commercial purpose, domestic purpose, or we and use in automobile sectors to store the battery in electricity, and that battery gives the charges to run the engines also. There is no here we are discussing about the tidal power. Tidal, the ray is and fall of tidal offer a means for storing water at the rise and discharge the same at fall. Of course, the heat of water available under such a case is very low, but the increase the catchment area. Consider amount of power can be generated as a negligible. Whatever the here that generation of power by tides or tidal power, we can say that the tidal power, with the help of the tidal power we can generate the power. Here the dam one side tidal basin is there, and other side is high tidal is there, sea. High tidal is sea. Sea means in boundaries of sea is we are putting the turbine, and in that turbine the flowing of water from the turbine and leaving of water is generating with the mechanical energy, and it is converting into the electrical energy. But the head of water available under such case very low and increase the catchment area, but the catchment area of the water will be increased. That's why the power will be generated, but negligible cost. But the cost will be negligible. The whatever the cost is requirement for this purpose to generate the power, that is negligible. You can see here the high tidal point value will decrease because of it is supplying from the turbine, and the water will goes out the turbines. In that section, the mechanical energy is converted to electrical energy. Like this, the electrical energy is producing from the sea water with the help of mechanical components. But the if the high tidal point is there in that sea, that is good advantage of to generate the electricity. Nowadays, in our seas, the capacity of water is less. That's why the produce that's less. So in that case, that in left hand side tidal basin having if sometime that high tidal value is more, that tidal value is going out from the turbine to the tidal basin. Here we are generating the electricity. If it is tidal basin is more, that tidal basin water capacity will goes to reverse section in the low tidal sheet. Like this, the up and down direction of water with the help of the mechanical component run forward to backward, forward to backward, we are generating the power. It's a good advantage of tidal power to generating any power. The uses of tidal for electric power generally is partially few favorable situation side where the geograph of inlet by favor the construction as a large scale, but the construction area will be large. That's why the if the water will goes the high tidal point to the to the turbine and leaving from the turbine in the tidal basin. If it is the point of tidal is low compared to the tidal basin, that the tidal basin value of water will be reverse in the turbine. There is no damage for the turbine because of the element of component of mechanical is run either it is clockwise direction or it is anti-clockwise direction. We can easily produce the tidal power. Hydroelectric plant to harden the tidal and dam would be built across the mouth of the bay. We have to take care where it is the we have to install the turbine and at the place of nozzle and where it is the supply of water from the sea is more at that point. We have to see first and then only we can easily install the turbines or bay in which the large gates and low head hydraulic turbine would be installed. At the time of high tides, the gates are open. At the time of the sea level is high, the gate will opens, and in that gate the water will supply to the turbine, and that flowing of water after the mechanical components after the mechanical components the turbines outlet the water will goes. So here the open and after storing the water in the ideal ways, the gates are closed. After the high tidal point will comes to down position, the gates will be closed. We are already see about these things in our last 2 or 3 months back, or maybe I think of 5 to 6 months back, the rain was going on at the time of movement. The sea's boundaries are collapsed, and that water will comes under in our areas also. That flowing of water capacity is more. Like this, the flowing of capacity is more in that dam sections also. So that comes under in dams. If it is the high tidal point will be reached, at the time of movement, we have to open the doors to control the level of the water. With the help of hydraulic head between the basin and water, and open the sea, ocean, and the water is allowed to flow back to the sea if the low tidal point will be there. So today we are discussing about these all things. In that inshallah, in the next class, we will the last one is you can say the geothermal energy. In many places, the earth natural steam escape from a surface vent, such as natural steam well, suggested the possibility of tapping terrestrial heat or geothermal energy. Geothermal is energy is the energy to form or using for the development of power. For if the power is generated, and then power we how if the requirement is more, how we will be develop the power? With the help of geothermal energy, we can develop the, and unfortunately the location where the steam produces substrata seem to be a fairly close to the surface or far removed from the center of civilization, where the power should be useful, employed. Nevertheless, there are probably many places where although no natural steam vent vent or hot spring are showing, deep drilling might tap as sources of under the steam. We have to deep drilling might taps to source of under the steam. To the cost of such exploration and the great likelihood of an unsuccessful conclusions are not very conducive to exploration of these sources of energy. The geothermal energy, for here we are, you can see that the there are two ways of electric power production for geothermal energy. The first one is heat energy is transferred from working fluid which operate by power cycle. The second one is the hot geothermal water or steam is used to operate from turbine directly. Here we are operating from turbine, here we are operating from power cycle. Now we are just looking up the diagram of geothermal power plant condensate for local use, cooling water. First, dry wet steam. We are passing in the dry wet steam in that water separator. In that water separator, here the steam and water molecules are separate, and the steam turbine, here the turbines produce the steam more efficiently and then generate the power. Here, with the help of combustion, we are generating the power. Whatever the water particles is there, it goes from the jet condenser and it's cool and it's become of totally water and it is left out from the condensate. Okay, these are the procedure of the geothermal zone. We are giving here the dry wet steam. Dry wet steam means water molecules content is there. Here the suppression of water molecule contents, and the steam is generated. That is, steam is going from the combustion and generate the power also. Okay. Next, presently only the steam coming out from ground is used to generate the electric The hot water is discarded because it contains as much as 30% dissolved salt and minerals. These causes serious rust damage to the turbine. That drive it seems having a 30% salt and minerals. That's why it may be the damage for the turbine. The water, however, contain more than 1/3 of water will be there in thermal energy. That water will separate it from the turbine. Water separator is there. In that water separator, the water will separate and goes from the turbine only, and the steam will go from in that directly to generate the power in that generator. That generator runs with the help of steam and then produce the electricity. Thermoelectric power. What is thermoelectric power? The last topic. According to Seebeck effect, we already know about the Seebeck effect. When the two ends of loop of two dissimilar metal, these are the two dissimilar metals, and these are the two ends are held at a different temperature, an electromagnetic force is developed in that. While currently they are flows in loop, if they are flowing in that loops, these methods selection of for the suitable material for different type of suitable material can be also used for the power generation also. Seebeck effect for the two dissimilar metals for different electromotive force for the developing purpose. These are the types of method we can use in that power generation also, and it is involve the law initial cost and negligible operating cost. Here we can negligible the operating cost also. So thank you very much for listening my lecture 2. Make sure to give your comment section your attendance. Next we will discuss about the different types of turbines is also there and the procedure, and later in that section of classes if it is the problem, problems is there, we will discuss also problems. Okay, make sure to give the attendance your within the time within the time of your period. Okay, have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.